Welcome to Time in the Shade in Shady Oak Ministries, and now the fake news. Despite the plain statement made by Jesus in the Synoptic Gospels regarding the day and hour of his return being intentionally unknown to man, a loophole has been discovered in Matthew 24:36. No man knows the day or the hour, but nothing prevents a woman from becoming a false prophet too. In Fairfax High School of Virginia, a Muslim girl was assaulted and had her hijab removed by Islamophobes. Over 300 students gathered in protest to support the young woman who was persecuted by bigots over her religion. I think we can all learn from this as a reminder that... What? Oh, she made it all up? Never mind then.
Before he humiliates us anymore.
The Watchtower Bible and Tract Society claimed that, like Jesus' apparent spiritual resurrection, his return will also be spiritual. Read all about this and more in page 196 of their LGBT manual.
Why are you gay?
New evidence has been discovered verifying the Book of Mormon. Read all about it in the front page article of the New Archaeology magazine titled, quote, Things That Never Happened.
Isn't that a daisy?
Critics of the Bible have discovered an example of God being immoral. In the book of 2 Kings 22:22, the prophet Micaiah informed King Ahab that he was being deceived by revealing that God allowed a lying spirit to speak through his pagan priests. And as we all know, telling someone you're being lied to makes you a liar.
You can take my word for it!
Chris Tyson has responded to accusations of him grooming his child with the calm and reasonable rhetoric we all know hedonist activists tend to make. Just because he's cross-dressing him, posing inappropriate photos of him online, and forcing him to understand marital relationships entirely from a hedonistic worldview means nothing. If being a man no longer means being a man, then I'm certain that being a groomer no longer means being a groomer.
I can think of a few new words.
And that'll be all for this week. Thank you all for joining us. Good night, and God bless you.